question which we have is in this financial crisis, economic crisis, what innovation strategies should companies be actually pursuing?
Of those companies around, but for instance, one of our board members is Cisco. Cisco is not worried about cash flow. CEO of that type of company, I would be concentrating on how I put as much distance between me and my competition at the time when the competition can afford to do the things I can afford to do. So some of the expensive innovations could be now the time to invest. For the vast majority of small businesses and businesses that or CEOs that I know, however, they're in the unfortunate position of being in a company without large cash reserves, and cash is king at the moment, which means that really there are only three things on the agenda. One thing on the agenda, survival. Three things that I would drive, obviously driving revenues, lowering costs, and increasing my working capital. So how do you do it? In terms of driving revenues, repackage what you're doing to fit with the downturn. So for example, yes, 68% of corporates have cut their HR spending, but our shareholder here is increasing their corporate sales because they're offering online English education instead of face-to-face English education, instead of packaging it as a cost saving to the HR departments. Hult's doing a similar thing. We're offering MBAs as an alternative for outplacement services instead of just a service payment. People can take an MBA instead of corporate. So there are opportunities out there, and all of these things are innovation, but they're not capital-intensive innovations, and they are not long lead time innovations. They're tomorrow, or what can I do this afternoon in innovations.
So bring it back to innovation. I think it's a very valid point, because the question of what role does innovation play in the broader strategy is exactly what companies are facing today. And I think there's two things we'll look at. It's all from the traditional consulting answer, which I can't really hear yet, which is the answer is it depends. Depending on where you're at in this marketplace, this could be a fantastic time to be operating in an innovation space. So you look at, for example, what Hyundai has done with their market assurance program. So if you buy a Hyundai and you lose your job next year, they'll take the car back at full price. So it's a different business model opportunity. What they're using, though, is the consumer's willingness in this economy to trade off what they might have liked to have purchased, like a Toyota, in exchange for a Hyundai to tie into the emotion that you probably saw on those slides before. This gives them a huge opportunity to introduce an entire segment of the marketplace to a car product they might not have considered in good times. But now in down times, they still need that car, and the car just died. Maybe they'll consider a Hyundai this time. So looking for opportunities where the consumer's behavior is being changed as a result of this, and what they're willing to trade off now, may be an opportunity for you to move into new segments of the market and capture some loyalty and capture some trial. I think the other thing is to say, let's not stop innovation in this regard, but let's be sure we prove our efforts. And this, as an innovation leader, should actually be your job. Don't wait for management to come to you and say, I'm whacking 50% of your staff because I've seen no results. Go to management and say, I'm voluntarily going to shutter these three projects at this time because I don't think they're appropriate for our organization. Look for opportunities to give back resources. A lot of times, in good times, innovation teams get bloated. You get representatives from 100 different organizations who all want to be on the innovation team. Now you find that they're distracted, their day job is kind of busy, they don't think they're going to get credit for working with the innovation team. So they start to leave anyway. Voluntarily push them out. Shrink back to two or three core people and really start to get some things done and prove that the model is working. And you can actually come through this very strong with a much more balanced portfolio, to the point we just heard, where you can come out of the downturn stronger than your competition because you didn't abandon it entirely, but you improved and focused it appropriately.
Good, thank you.